New video here as kids in a baseball league run for cover amid some terrifying moments. Now, you can't see it here, but there was gunfire in a police-involved shooting that took the life of an 82-year-old man. CBS 4's Peter Dench is live in Margate. Tonight, we're hearing from that man's son as police say they had no choice but to fire, but so close to kids, Peter.
That's right, Elliot. This is where it all happened, in Northwest 1st Street and Rock Island Road. Margate police say they were forced to fire after the man refused several commands to drop his weapon and actually pointed it in their direction. His son, though, says he has a lot of questions.
He was an old, frail man. He was 82. He had hard of hearing. He was a good man. He certainly didn't deserve to die like this.
Tony Suarez wants to know why his father, Jose Antonio Suarez, seen here in these family photos, was shot and killed by Margate police.
I don't have the truth yet. I need to see the body cameras. I'd like to, you know, that certainly is not characteristic of my father.
It all happened at 12:46 Sunday afternoon, prompting these baseball players in the Margate Legacy 13 and Under League to run for cover. You hear their screams. Margate police say Suarez was waving his firearm and shooting into the ground, and despite several commands to drop his weapon, he pointed it in their direction. One officer shot and killed him.
And he was on this side of the pavement waving the gun in the air, and they told him a couple of times to drop the gun. He did not. And he put the gun up in the air and he fired a couple of shots.
Ultimately, he forced the officer to have to fire upon him. By putting the lives of the officers in danger, and actually he was putting citizen lives in danger as well.
Suarez's son says his father was under a great deal of pressure.
His wife has dementia, and his bathrooms, he had mold in the house, and you know that was making him and his wife ill, and so he was stressed out about that. He even told his doctor that he wanted to kill himself. He wanted to die, not kill himself. He wanted to die. That he wished he could catch COVID.
Now, amid those questions about his father's death, Tony Suarez says he's coming to South Florida tomorrow. The officer involved with the shooting has been placed on administrative leave, which is standard policy. Meanwhile, FDLE is investigating the shooting. We are live in Margate. Peter Dench, CBS 4 News.
Peter, thank you for that live update.